Karam, everybody. So I'm doing a recording for an online tutorial, or let's say an online class for your yoga asanas practice, or the physical postures of yoga. But before everything else, a good short background for the guidelines of this practice. Very important is that you should not have a heavy meal 2 to 3 hours before and even after. You have to have a committed environment, free from smoke and dust. Take a half bath or even a full shower if you can. Comfortable clothing to let your skin breathe. Practice on a mat and a blanket for sanitation. Check nostril flow. Should be more on the left side. Keep a pace. Practice slow and keep away from cold water after practice. Okay, so while we are here, let's start. I'd like you to relax and stay calm. Go over your breath right now. Sit comfortably. If you have a mat, you prepare a couple of mats or a blanket. Make you more comfortable throughout the practice. So while you're there, I'd like you to focus on your breath. Be connected. Sit comfortably with your legs crossed. If you can't, you can just place a pillow underneath your thighs, or just sit on the top of a pillow or some folded blankets or mats. In this practice, or in this situation or scenario, you should be calm. Find this very important part of your day, or time of your day, where you set an intention. Be clear. I'd like you to sit comfortably. Sit with your eyes closed for the meantime. I'd like you to connect not just with the position, but to connect your attention within. Breathe. Breathe calmly. And let's start with a few breath connection exercises. Very common practice. We hold the sides of our belly. So as we inhale, we take the breathing and belly goes out to go through the diaphragm. And as you breathe out, your belly goes in, ribcage collapses, belly draws into your spine. Again, inhaling, belly expands, and exhaling, belly contracts. Inhaling, and exhaling. I'm going to try to take a little bit of movement as you look up into your inhale. And as you exhale, you look down. Again, inhale, looking up. And exhale, looking down. Particularly, we have about 4 counts over the inhale, just to create a rhythm and a pattern. So you look over to the left side now. 3 and 4. Back to the center. Inhale. And as you exhale, look to your right. 1, 2, 3, and 4. And as we simply go back to the center, inhale. Start rolling the shoulders up and down. Really feeling around the joints of your shoulders. Always keep the back straight the whole time here. And after 1, we go reverse, just about 4 times, rolling over. You can take more time with this. You can pause the video and just continue a few more rounds, about 4 or 8 rounds. This time we're inhaling, going forward as you bring your chest out. And as you exhale, round your back, belly goes in. Inhaling, leaning forward. Chest goes out, arching the back slightly. Exhale, rounding the back. Belly goes in. Again, inhale, forward to the front. And then exhale, goes in. And I'd like you to just start moving very gently. These are dynamic poses for your thighs, to just get them to open up. You can do a few, about 8 rounds over each side. as you push the thigh over to the side, just to get the movements around your hips. Do that a few rounds. Let's do the left side now. Just free breathing right now. Again, if you can, keep a pattern. About four counts inhale and four counts exhale. Again, what's important, as I would like to emphasize, is to create a rhythm. I'd like you to get your stretched out legs in front of you, and with your back straight, I'd like you to point your toes up to the ceiling right now. As you inhale, try to bend your knee alternately, your heels moving towards your groins and your knee to the chest. Again, straight legs, inhale, exhale, knee bending. Inhale straight, and then exhale. Inhale straight legs, exhale, knee bending. Alternately, this time to the right, exhale, bending. Inhale and exhale. One more time. So this time, let's reach our arms above our heads here. As we stretch out, inhale, exhale, bring the hands over to the sides and down to the floor, keeping the back straight the whole time. Inhale, arms up. And exhale, hands down. So your legs are just stretched out the whole time with your toes pointing up to the ceiling. With your breath, inhale, lift the arms above your head, reaching up top. And exhale, hands over your sides. Again, inhaling, arms reaching up above your head. And exhale, bring it over to the side. Again, feel free to enjoy more of that as you pause the video and repeat another set, another round. This time we go into our all fours. We call the quadruped position. With your hands and knees, make sure that you are evenly in line with your shoulders, towards your wrist, your hips, towards your knees. And this is a very basic form. I'd like you to instill that with you. Let's inhale, look up. Arch your back, tailbone up. Exhale, round your back, tailbone in, and chin to the throat. Again, inhale, arch your back, looking up. And exhale, round your back. Continue a few more rounds. Inhale. And exhale. Inhaling. And exhaling. Now, let's start to reach our right leg over to the back, straight up. Inhale, exhale, bend it over, bring it towards your forehead or your nose. And as you stretch that leg out, you look slightly forward to the front. Inhale. And as you exhale, bring them in, your knee to the nose. Again, inhale, leg to the back. Exhale, knee to the nose. Inhale, leg to the back. Exhale, knee to the nose. And let's do the other side. Inhaling, leg to the back. Exhale, knee to the nose. Inhale. And exhale, just rounding the back beautifully. Moving the legs over to the back, making sure you are evenly squared with your hands together in that same space and spot. And your knee in that space. All right, so we're gonna move gently with some preparation. I'd like you to connect to your left arm and right leg racing up together as you inhale. Inhale and up with your right arm, left leg. Exhale down. Inhale. Just make sure you move in a stable form as you reach out. And you land both the hands and the knees on the same spot. Beautiful. As you inhale and exhale, bring it down. Again, inhaling and exhale. Inhale and exhale. Particularly, we move with a form, and that's one movement form each breath. So we're trying to learn that, try to learn to take our time and be in the process. So right now, evenly squared with your hands about as wide as your shoulders, And this we're going to try to work on some dynamic preparations for this we call the mountain position, or we commonly call the downward facing dog. So with your hands pushing your hips up to the back, you're keeping the back straight all the way from your pelvis all the way down to your hands in a slope position. You're pressing your heels down at the back. You may not be seeing that in this video, but I think you know what to do. Your heels down, you're bending your knees alternately. It's like you're walking in place. Let's alternately work on the right foot to the front, just preparing ourselves for our flowing salutations later on. As you inhale, you look up. Try to work that position out. If you can't do that comfortably, you can just look forward. And let's do that on the other side. Now let's do the dynamic positions again. And making sure that we get to have this this position become comfortable later on. This might not be comfortable for most. So you step the left foot to the front, right knee down, and you inhale, lift your chest up. And as you exhale, step your left foot over to the back. That's it. Just continue on. Just doing that beautifully. Now we're going to mark our position over here as we lean back and go forward, chin and forehead, or chest and forehead. Then your chin and hip down, and you're going to lift your chest. This is the proper way we go up on our cobra as we inhale. And then we curl the toes under and push our hips up and back into mountain pose. So just continue to be dynamic in this mountain pose, or we call the downward facing dog. Just continue to breathe and just let your head fall down comfortably. Now let's try to step both of our legs forward, or foot in between our hands. And just keeping the fingers down. Let's look halfway forward as we inhale. And as we exhale, bring your head down. Inhale again. And then exhale, head down. Just doing this dynamically. Inhale, exhale, preparing to engage our backs. Inhale, and then exhale. A few rounds more. Inhale, exhale. Ideally, we do 8 rounds if we can, or maybe 5. All right, inhale, and then exhale, head down. Just getting more dynamic for your forward bends standing. Reach your arms out to the front, arms beside your ears as you look over your head. Inhale and reaching up. Now let's lean a bit to the back here, just to make sure that you have a good modification. Make sure you just go as far as you can. If it's too much, you can just stop. You can even stay with your arms reaching out. As we bring the hands in between our forehead and our heart, we're going to stop right here for a few breaths. We call this position Samasthiti. And you keep your hands to the heart. Now starting with this standing position, try to inhale, reaching your arms up. And if you can, lean over to the back. Urvastasana, or upward arm raise. As you exhale, you bend forward, your belly to your thigh, and head down. Or slightly bent knees if you need to. Step your right foot to the back, right knee down, and lift your chest away from your thighs as you inhale. As you exhale, step your left foot over to the back, both your legs together, knees down. Pull your pelvis to the back and go forward with your chest and your forehead, and then drop your hips and chin down as you inhale. Your cobra.
Follow the sun.
And you exhale, curl your toes and
which way the wind
move up to your mountain. We stay here normally for about 4 breaths at least. Again, particular pattern
breathe,
is still there.
Being
very,
the air,
very aware of the breath.
Set your intentions.
Inhale.
Dream with care.
And exhale.
Tomorrow's a new day for everyone. A brand new moon, brand new sun.
Step your right foot to the front, in between your hands, left knee down. And you're going to go inhaling, your chest away from your thighs. Make sure the knees are just above your foot and head down as you exhale. As you look forward, inhale, bring your arm over your head and reaching your arms above your head and leaning back according to how you can, what you can do.
So follow.
Inhale, and as you exhale, bring your hands to your mind back
sun,
to your samasthiti.
The direction
of
the
second round
birds,
now, starting from the center.
Direction
again,
of love.
As you bring your arms
breathe,
over your head. You can even bring your hands to the mirror position. And leaning backwards.
Cherish a small
as you exhale, folding forward. With your
cherish
arms beside your ears and keeping the back straight, head down again. If you can, press your palms down.
Tomorrow's a new day.
Left knee down to the floor, step your foot back. As you inhale, lift your chest away from your thighs.
Brand new moon,
and as you exhale,
brand
step
new
your
sun.
Right foot over to the back into mountain pose.
When you
left
feel
knee down,
life
pull
coming
hip to the back,
down
chest
on you
forehead, and
like
chin.
A heavy weight.
Lift the chest, inhale.
When you feel
then
this crazy society adding to the strain,
really
take a stroll to the nearest water's edge. Remember your place. Many moons have risen and fallen long, long before you came. So which way is
inhale.
The wind blowing? What does your heart say?
Exhale. That inhale again, looking forward to the front, stepping the same foot, left foot to the front, right knee down, and chest away from your thighs, equestrian pose. Exhale and step your right foot forward and bring your head down. Inhale, arms forward and up, and as far as you can, or just staying up there with your arms raised up. And as you exhale, bringing back your hands into
follow the sun. Which way the wind blows.
Beautifully taking this pause as we stop. Again, do a few more rounds. Inhale, reaching arms up, Urvastasana, upward arm raise. Exhale, forward bending all throughout the hips, folding head down. Right foot to the back, right knee down to the floor. Equestrian pose, inhale, lifting the chest up. Exhale, left foot over to the back. Drop the knees down to the floor, hips back. In between your hands, chest, forehead, chin and hips. Inhaling, Bhujangasana or the snake pose. And then exhale, curl the toes back into your Parvatasana, or we call the mountain pose. Stay for a few breaths here, quality breaths. If your mind gets distracted, it sways away, go back and even do your form properly. You can press the heels down if you can, if there aren't any restrictions on your thighs. Another way to resolve the whole tightness around you. Now looking in between your hands, stepping your right foot forward, left knee comes down to the floor, inhaling. Looking up, exhaling, stepping your left foot forward and bending forward, head down. Inhale, arms forward, looking up or leaning back if you can. And as you exhale, bring your hands back into a prayer position, mind and heart. Again, centering yourself, feeling the ground, taking some time here before you do the next round. Inhale again, bring the hands up above your head, leaning over to the back. And as you exhale, forward bending. Stepping your right, left foot. Step your left foot over to the back now. Left knee down and lift your chest up. And as you exhale, step your right foot back. knees down to the floor. Chest and forehead, chin and hips. Inhale, Bhujangasana, or a cobra position. And exhale, curl your toes. Parvatasana, mountain pose. Again, 4 to 8 breaths. Each cycle goes on with an inhale and an exhale. Inhale. And exhale. Okay, looking forward. Left foot to the front again in between your hands, right knee down. Inhale, looking up. Exhale, and right foot forward and bring your head down. Dhanasana. Arms forward, reaching up. Inhale, and upward arm raise. And exhale, right back to the heart. You know, sometimes even here while I'm doing this, I may have been closing my eyes for you to just see how it is being done. Let's try another round. Inhale, three sides. In this form, inhaling with your eyes closed the whole time. Leaning back if you want. It's a total immersion. Bending forward as you exhale. Immersion to an inner world experience. Right foot to the back. Right knee down. And make sure you move your hip forward to the front while you're doing this. As you exhale, left foot to the back, knees down again to the floor. This is a very emphasized hold. Or let's say retention of the breath. As you inhale, then you go up into your cobra position. And then you exhale back into your mountain position. Again, as I was saying, when your eyes are closed, you are going through a very, very good process of tuning into your internalization. All that there is are purely internalized movements. Rather than focusing merely only on the external portions, we are highly connecting towards the inner sensations, guided by the breath, exhaling through. Now you look forward to the front, step your right foot in between your hands, left knee down, and then lifting your chest up again. And then you exhale, left foot forward and bend down. Up to the knee if you can. Arms forward as you inhale, reaching up and even leaning back if you can. And as you exhale, back to your mind and heart center. Samasthiti means equally standing. As you assess that, try to open your legs about as wide as your hips as you stand up. And we're going to do some standing poses. Very, very basic standing pose. We step your right foot to the back. Your arms extending out, arms length, facing your body to the side. And we're going to lean over to the left. Let's start with a basic form, level 1. Forearm to your thigh, reaching your arm up. Now, make sure that you're really extending those elbows. Your arms beside your ears and you're looking up to your palms. You can stay here for 8 breaths, or some of which can do further. So that's an option. You can reach your hands down to the floor, which we'll be doing after another breath or so. Inhale. Exhale. Your left hand may come down to the floor here. So you can choose just any of the two. You can do the first one for about 4 breaths, or this one for about 5 breaths. It's up to you. Just do what you can. This may be inaccessible for most. You just do what you can. Make sure your neck is not dropping off the line of the spine. And then you come up. Inhale. Hands to prayer. Back to Samasthiti. And standing straight. Now we move on to the other side. Just go ahead and step that left foot over to the back. Make sure your body is facing the left side now. Arms are straight. Inhale, exhale. Right forearm to your thigh. So this is going to be level one, the most accessible one. Left arm over your head. So making sure that really is a slope from the finger down to your heel. Just breathing through the side body where you are, leaning over. And you can adjust your legs though, as far as you can comfortably hold. Knee is just right above the heel. All you're doing here is just sensing. Again, I'm showing you here how to go over the other version of that, which you can actually go a little bit deeper. Again, according to your pace, what you can do, just do what you can. Breathing in and out. Now as you take an inhale, coming right up, and as you exhale back to your hands to prayer, samastiti. It's very important that you really stop every time so you can internalize every position. So we're going to go do a variation of balancing so that you can all connect to your ground with your left foot now. Holding your left hand or right ankle with your left hand, reach your right arm up. Now you can do this with eyes open or your eyes closed. Usually we stay for half a minute, okay, or let's just say about five really dedicated breaths. I'd like to emphasize the word dedicated right here. Inhale. And exhale. Good. Try to grab your ankle and pull the knee over to the back for a little so that we can connect towards the back portion of our body. Let's do the other side now. Your left ankle held by your right hand. I'm gonna stand up straight. Once again, dedicated breaths. I'm perfectly imperfect and I'm only here to live. Inhale on the evil on the path. And exhale. And making sure the knee is somewhat below the level of your hip. And it's in line with your ankle being held by your hand. This position is a variation of tree. As you pull the knee back, it creates a very good balance. Now for the position. Okay, let's all come on our knees. Wherever you are, whoever you are right now practicing this, I'd like you to take a little stop. This position is somewhat a mudra, or we call it gesture. I'd like you to just stop right here. You can do this with toes pointed, or with some pillows underneath your ankles or rolled towels. I'm not able to show that to you now, but just picture it out. You can pause the video and try that so it makes you feel more comfortable. Now what we're doing now is we're going to do a basic form of back bend. We call this the camel pose. You're just going to lean back. In this connection, we are pointing the posture to address the need of the times, which we call the pandemic, you know, the coronavirus. So what I'd like you to do is to do this position. This is very important. This connects your heart and your cardiorespiratory connection with your system and your energy systems. So after doing, again, dedicated breaths with that, you take a break on this position. Your fingers pointing down, chin down to your throat. Throat lock, I should say. Now let's do a second round. Now you can usually do four rounds if you like. You can repeat this video to take a pause again. So in this second round, I'm doing the next variation, which would be intermediate. You can go grab onto your heels. You can also do this with toes tucked. My toes right now are pointed, so you can do a toe stuck position over this one. Go inhaling again. And exhaling. Making sure also that you keep off compressing the back of your neck. to just look comfortably up, feeling a bit of stretch in the throat, not too much compression on the arching of your neck here. And as you go back to recover, simply sit back, chin curled in, hands down. You can even round your back even more with this. Just for an option. Just connecting, very important. In this video, I'm emphasizing how you really take a good attention over connecting your position and your mind. In yoga, we connect both. So let's do this butterfly position, your foot together, and we flap those knees up and down. If you want, you can go a little higher, and don't worry, you're not going to hit the knee in the floor. It's just going to bounce off through your thighs. You can close your eyes while you're doing this. Creates again that whole internal attention. Now we're just going to sit up in this position, and we connect the knees over to the sides. Your foot would be opened like a book when you're opening a book. As you lengthen the back, inhale, and as you exhale, you're gonna bend forward. With either your forehead down into the floor, and you can stay as long as you can, about 8 breaths if you can stay there. And slowly inhale, coming right back up. And again, holding for a bit. Extend one leg out to the front. Start with your left leg forward to the front. Inhale, keeping the back straight. And here, I'll show you first technique, what you're going to do if you can't really keep the leg straight. As you reach forward and down, notice that I'm going to slightly bend my knees here. And keep my head to the knee, which is how the position is called. Let's do the other side. Again, you can pause this video and repeat this for about 4 rounds maximum, or you can just do 2. Let's do the other side. Inhale. As you exhale, if you can keep the back straight here, so bring your head to the knee. Take about 5 dedicated breaths. Inhale and come back up. And let's work on to our twist. Now some people cannot do their foot across here, so it's just easy. You can bring the foot in line with your groins. Here's a twist, a rotation of the spine. So just hug your thighs as you rotate. Look comfortably to the back. Showing you the basic position. Some of you that have been doing this for a while, you can bring your arm across the other thigh. And let's do the other side. Inhale. And just tugging, showing you a very fundamental form here. As you exhale, twisting over to the other side. Working on the rotation of your spine. Stimulating most of the organs around the belly, the sides. And this is beautiful effect of detoxification. The result of this position. So we're here boiling down to our lymphatic, or let's say self-massage. Very important system we need to inculcate after every practice we do. We do this as a form of a good maintenance system. You rub your palms together and bring it heating up to your sides, you massage your head, your ears, using your fingers, create the circulation. For more information about this, we are undergoing a training program, which is in the Yoga Academy of Cebu. And we have all the information right there and how you go about each of the processes we do here, each of the postures, what are the purpose of each pose, and how it affects your glands. What is the yogic system of breath and attention? As we are massaging, we are doing here a lymphatic structure, or we call the lymph flow. As we are rubbing, very important you understand how we develop the synovial fluid connection here towards our hormonal secretions and harmonious aggressions would mean a good emotional balance, and that's what we're doing. We're now over to the fingers, and again, all of these information that you're gonna learn, just join us. We have learning sessions every now and then. We are undergoing trainings all across the year, and you're free to join. Right now, we're doing a certain method of just going around our body just to facilitate this movement. This time, we're doing the fingers around the navel. Inhale and exhale. This is called the Agni. Agni means fire. Agni Saramudra. For those of you who wants to lose weight, to regulate their metabolism and kick the fire back starting, this is the best mudra or gesture to follow and learn, with a bit of some intention going on with this and proper guidance. You can learn this process. So exhale belly in and holding it in. Yes, and just massaging through your thighs. This motion is just basic. You can also learn this in lymphatic massages. So we're going over the left side now, just massaging the ankles. Usually the joint systems is a hub for the energy excess of your body. Much of the energy stored would accumulate over the joints. So very important to learn why we're doing this, and why learning this from the proper mentors is also key for you to be able to understand and apply this later on at your own, in your own space. What is important is you learn this first properly. And what I'm doing right now is I'm just bouncing off my heels. And again, just to let you know that this is connected with the whole point systems of your body, and the areas that we're stimulating here is not just the muscles, the fascia. A lot of it is much more on, if you know Chinese medicine, which is the meridian points, and right now we're working on the whole reflex points. You see that on my foot. Massaging. If you want, you can put some more pressure by using the elbows, or if you got a good enough pinching strength, you can do your fingers, you can do your thumbs. Yeah, for those that are stronger with your fingers. And yeah, you can continue doing that. The certain reflex points we're hitting around here, just moving generally, except that the certain points like this is being manipulated, and just massaging through. It's really self-care we're doing here, and we're now moving the energy around, just passing it through down to the toes, just throwing it out. But we don't need any of those negative feelings and tension and all the scare. And we're now rolling over our backs, just letting this whole definite connection of body and mind connect within us as we're lying down comfortably in this position. So again, you can pause this video and stay with it for like 5 to 10 minutes, just being aware of your breath the whole time, moving your attention to each part of your body to let it relax. This is not sleeping. Please don't mistake this with sleeping. This is relaxation. Take your time. Breathe through your nose. Breathe through your belly. Move your attention to every part of you that you become relaxed. From the toes to your hips, fingers to your arms, your whole back, your whole front, your neck and your throat, your head, even to the skin, you're relaxed. Stay right here for a few more breaths. now. Let's assume that you have paused this video or just listened to good music on the background here. We're gonna start moving. Start with the left knee hugging on to your belly and your chest, hugging it in. We call this posture Bhastrikasana. With your right knee now. So there's also a method of doing this posture, and you can learn this thoroughly. And after a while, you roll on your right. Very important, before you come up, you don't hurry. Please do not hurry. Just take your time. And after that, we're gonna find our way to come up from this side. It's very important we roll over to the right before we come up slowly with your left hand pushing the ground. And here I'm just gonna sit back up right away. Usually we stop, but for now, I'm gonna go to seated position. And we're gonna do a very, very short meditation right now. Just close your eyes. And as we come too close, you bring the palms together. As you rub the palms, heat up, place it to your eyeballs, and then we're gonna more slowly, gently move your eyeballs away. And you open your eyes also. Bring your palms together into the mind and heart. Namaskar to all of you. And thank you so much. Have a good day.